There he is. Question is whether that could possibly be the same fish or not.
I'm almost thinking a second fish.
You know, I had just missed a fish and cast into the same spot and instantly got another bite. So who can tell for sure, but these fish can be very, very aggressive at times. Oh my goodness. Come on, baby, play yourself out.
There we go.
Thank you, Travis. Look
nice
at that.
Fish, Mark.
Look at that. Look at here. Travis, thank you for sharing one of your pet fish with me, man.
Put them there last night.
Oh, these things are so pretty and they're so much fun to catch. You know, when you're using light tackle and the rod in your hand and feel the bite, watch the fish slash at the lures, it really is exciting. I mean, I've caught a lot of brown trout in my life. This is the first one I ever caught on a jerkbait.
Very That's
cool,
awesome.
Man. Very cool.
Such you a got, fun way to get them.
You got me, I'm hooked. No pun intended, I am definitely hooked. That is so much fun.
These fish are sure making a great living in Lake Superior. You know, if you look at the quality of that fish and how fat it is, you know, there's absolutely no shortage of food out here for them in the shallow water environment.
I had so much fun with him. Whoa, look at that. Little observation here to share with folks. Almost everything we fished today has been what I would describe as classic brown trout water. Creek mouse, stained water, fishing the stained plumes, and that's where we've been having our action. We're running from spot to spot and Travis pulls us into a place. And I commented when we got here, I goes, Travis, why would you even stop here? I wouldn't even give this a second look. But it's just a little small outcropping of rock surrounded by sand. I make a couple casts, bam, I got a fish on. But the interesting thing is, there's a very small piece of structure here that's holding fish, colder water than what we've been fishing, and certainly clearer water than what we've been fishing. So I just find it really interesting. And like I said, I would have never stopped here. Thanks for Travis picking this spot and pulling in here, because I'd have blown right by this. I didn't never gave it a second look.
Yeah, so that's right, Mario. That's a good point. This spot sure doesn't look like much when you pull up to it. We've got an extensive white sandy beach and it gradually transitions to rock. But what I've noticed in the past is that we've got a little bit of an irregularity in the shoreline here. So it's almost a 90 degree point that comes out. And what that does is it creates a little pocket that sort of traps warmer water. And as you can see, our wind's blowing us into shore right now. That's a key point, you know, a key consideration today is that all the warmer surface water that's happening today with the sun radiating is kind of accumulating in this tiny little nook. And that nook just so happens to coincide with a few pieces of structure that aren't very big, but can hold a lot of fish when those right conditions are present. So a little wrap there.
A little bit of wrap. It looks like he's oh, there he comes.
There he comes.
He got something there on his side, a little booger on his side.
Yeah.
So got a blemish, but.
Boy, they're scrappy. We got a couple good jumps out of him.
Oh, there we go.
There we go. Nice,
nice job, Travis.
Thank you.
Nice job. Travis, man, you got yourself a beautiful fish there.
That is gorgeous. Look at the spots on that one.
Oh, they're just absolutely drop dead gorgeous.
Aren't they?
And catching them on light tackle, jerk bait?
It's a blast.
Does it get much more fun than that?
No.
That is exactly what we came all the way to the Keweenaw to experience.
Oh, these are awesome fish.